here is our brand new piece. In fact, this premiered here at NAMM Thursday, the opening of NAMM at 10 a.m. They sent this to me literally. It's a prototype. They sent it to me last week and said, Steve, learn how to use this thing, and I did, and I'll show you some things on it in just a moment. This is a prototype. This is shipping, I believe, April or May. Price point should be similar to what the MK2 was. So this is kind of the successor to the MK2. And I'm showing it deliberately with one of our Hercules brand netbooks, just to show that if you have a small controller, you can run it with a small computer. It's not going to run as fast, clearly, as a dual core something or other, because it's a single core Atom processor, but it's going to do just fine. Let's pick ourselves a song. We'll pick off the list. We'll go straight off the list here. We'll go with, here we go. We'll do this one. Click the load button over to the right on deck B, and you start. I want to start from where the beat starts. So you back cue, get right behind that first beat. Beat detection's going here. What do we have? Here we go. Boom. 124 beats per minute at 0%. We can plus or minus 10 is what we have it set at now. So we take this knob and it's our pitch bend. And we have four effects buttons. Single beat loop. You can see it up on the screen. It's just the one beat going on the red side, back again and again and again. Two beat loop, which is a little more palatable than the one beat loop I just had, but it's all just a matter of trial, error, and preference. Four beat loop. Kind of hard to tell at this point because there's not much going on in the song. So let's forward through. We'll hit the forward button. Yeah, four beat loop. That's kind of good. And then if you press the shift button on the effects, you get four more effects. Flange. And you can stack them on top of each other. I got a four beat loop with a flange. And what's this one? This is the beat grid, sorry. Oh no, we went back to loop. Because it never gets out of the loop, it does that beat grid every single time it goes around. Then we let the loop out. And this one is a flip and double, which is the same song, one beat off, as if you're going very fast between vinyl or CDs. And then four we've got set for a backspin, which is a good way to get out of a song you're tired of, or get attention, or cover up a bad mix in some cases, let's be honest. Now you can use it as an effect. Let's say you're looking for a clean version of a song that you don't have a clean version of a song for. So every time the profanity comes, you go, Or you can spin it out to a complete stop. Symmetrical on the other side, so the same thing works on the other side. Let's mix something. We'll keep playing that song. Where are we at? 124, so we'll go. I'm going to do cooling again. So we'll load it with the load button on the left. Load A. The headphone automatically switches over. Well, let me show you the front controls. Here's our mic. Volume. Off and on to the mic right there. Volume here. Headphone volume. Monitor volume right there. I'm going to hit the sync button so we get right on. Okay, 124, 124. 4.9, bang, it's right on. Let me take the, here we go. Let's drop some bass on it. Backspin, get up. You know that, and that's kind of the basics of it. You know that, everything else is just a matter of practice and style.